G'day Trailblazers, my name is Cam, and for today's video, I'm going to showcase some of the brand new features and functions coming out in the new SFMC Companion Chrome extension. So I have downloaded and installed the new 0.3.0 version of SFMC Companion Chrome extension. I've logged into my Salesforce Marketing Cloud, and so we can now get started. And for those of you who already have the extension installed, it will download the new 0.3.0 in the background for you. When you click on the extension, you can always check what version you have by checking the bottom here. I'm on version 0.3.0. Now to start with, you may see there's a few new things in the interface. So we'll start things off though by refreshing our token as usual. This will then download the APIs that we need to start using the extension. You can see green lights across the board. The first thing is, just like we had in our previous version, we now have our data sources panel in our brand new tab interface. First thing we have to do, as usual, is to download some of these assets. Let's go and start off with our folders. As it's updating, I'll talk about our brand new tabs. These tabs are designed to give some more real estate to the app. We're having a few more features coming in the future. We want some more real estate to put those features into. So to start with, we have our brand new search tab. Now, our search tab, which is coming soon, we'll use to make some quick search features related to navigate and search for objects in your instance much more quickly, including real-time searching. The apps interface will be a new place for applications built on the SFMC Companion interface. We have a lot of great suggestions for features coming from the community. I want to have a nice space to put them in, so watch this space, be more coming soon. The info tab will contain some information about the extension. I'll add more in here. Of course, you can find more in the additional help and information tab. And finally, we have the alerts, a brand new feature in the version 0.3.0. This will be where our messages and alerts go through the extension, so anything that occur that may raise an alarm, you'll find in this panel here. Now, it's not quite fully fledged out just yet, a bit more work to be done, but as I start to build this out, you'll find more and more alerts get posted into this section of the extension. With that in mind, let's jump back onto the database and have a look how it's going. As you can see, our folders have now completed. You may have noticed it means we can now actually leave the extension and it will run in the background. Now downloading my data extensions, it's counting up 3, 4, 5. I can now leave the Chrome extension, let it close in the background, and come back to it. It will keep progressing from 5, 6, 12, 13, there we go. So brand new feature, you can now close the extension and go about your day, and will download all its assets in the background. So what we can also do is run multiple things in the same time. Now once the data extensions are done, I do recommend you leave the folders to finish first, data extensions second, and once they're done, you can run the rest of them. So we're almost finished, and while that finishes, let's navigate over to Automation Studio. I'll show some more features as this loads in. So over in Automation Studio, and we'll check on the extension's progress, and we've now got data extensions completed. Now let's update our filters, queries, automations, ETLs, SSJS, and all of them. Click, 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 just like that. They're all downloading all at the same time, and the best part is I can leave the extension to close. It's going to go back and do it all in the background for us. There we go. Complete, complete, complete. It's all being downloaded. Fantastic. So that done, let me show you some of the new cool features of our brand new interface. Now I can jump into one of my automations here, my CAM test automation. I'll show you the first thing I'm really excited about. I can jump into my workflow. I can jump onto one of my activities here and joke on the little the drop down here. And I'll find some new parts of the widget. Of course, the usual replace, edit, and delete, but now we have two new features, the view in SFMC Companion. I can click that, it's going to launch the extension for me, and I can now find my usual interface on the Companion. I can navigate through like usual, but it just means I can go straight from my automation directly into that activity, just like that. Now what's more fun in my opinion is the second drop-down, the launch activity. Now, you'll have those automations that are running, they've been activated, they may be schedules or file drops. Once your automation is activated, you of course cannot go back in and modify the existing activities. You have to pause your automation, then you can go in and view and edit it. Well, not anymore. You can jump into the launch activity and launch the activity directly from your running automation, which means no more pausing those business critical activities to find where those SQLs or import activities are stored. So I've jumped into an SQL activity here and you may find already another feature, brand new in version 0.3.0. We can now hijack part of the interface to bring in additional information about your activities in your instance. So straight away, my SQL query activity here, you can see my activity posted like usual. On the left-hand side, I can now see my target data extension, what's going to be updated as a result of the activity. I can click on that, and it's going to load into my contact builder for me and find that data extension and show me the properties. And so here it is here. Here's my data extension, my contact delete. And best of all, some more interface changes. I can now see that this data extension in Contact Builder is the target of a query. My contact analysis query. I can click on that and go back into my Automation Studio and find that SQL. Here it is here. Now, just like in the original SFMC Companion, we also have the ability to see what is being activated in this query, what data extensions are being referenced. And of course, these two are being referenced in my SQL. And scroll down here, and there is my Einstein predictive scores and my contact Salesforce data extension. I can jump back into my activity in Automation Studio and have a look at my really big query. And let's go and launch that activity inside of Automation Studio and have a look for what this one has. We have my CamDE. We've got our sample rows, and we've got some contacts to delete and some results. Lots of data extensions, and again, they are all shown on the side here. I can navigate through and find out that the CamDE is a part of this query. So click on that and jump into Contact Builder, and this DE is the target of some queries and also the source in some queries. Great. Some of those great interface functions of the SFMC Companion are being brought directly into your Marketing Cloud interface. Another new feature in the Companion is a brand new report. If we jump into our extension, I can jump onto my reports here. I can find my new business rules report. You can click on this and find a full download of your entire business rules set that's been set in your instance. Now, this will refresh every time you refresh your token. That's every time you click on the extension and refresh the tokens required. Once you do this, it's going to update your business rules, which you can then see for yourself. And just like the other reports, you can also click on the download as a CSV and download it directly to your desktop. And that's all the key highlights of version 0.3.0. You can always let me know what you think of the Chrome extension or any of these changes by right-clicking on the extension and choosing Options. On this page, you'll find the SFMC Companion Feedback and Bugs form. Use this form to fill out any bugs you found or any feature suggestions you may have as well. I love hearing your feedback and your comments, especially the ways you're using the extension to save your time and productivity when you use Marketing Cloud. Hope you enjoy version 0.3.0. If you do, let me know in the comments below. And please stay tuned as I release more updates in the future.